Dear students, this is audio number 23 for you. In previous audios, we have discussed about three fundamental identities and basically various things about trigonometric functions. Now we will proceed further and study trigonometric functions of compound angles. What is this compound angle? An angle formed by an algebraic sum of two or more angles. It's called compound angle. See, angle formed by algebraic sum of two or more angles. That means A plus B. Suppose A and B are two angles. Then A plus B, A minus B, 2A, 3A, etc. They are called compound angles. And we are interested in finding the results or finding the formulae of cos of A plus B, cos of A minus B, sine of A plus B, sine of A minus B, etc. So it all starts with the formula cos of A minus B, which you can geometrically derive. Cos of A minus B comes out to be cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. Cos of A minus B is cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. When it is cos of A plus B, it is cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. Now come to sin of A plus B. Sin of A plus B is sin A cos B plus cos A sin B. And sin of A minus B, it is sin A cos B minus cos A sin B. And once you get formulae for cos and sin, you can also get formula for tan of A plus B. You know, tan of A plus B is sin of A plus B upon cos of A minus B. Both these formulae we have. So you can manipulate, make some calculations and prove easily that tan of A plus B is tan A plus tan B upon 1 minus tan A tan B. And tan of A minus B, if you want to calculate, it is tan A minus tan B upon 1 plus tan A tan B. So these six formulae, they are actually first few formulas of spectrum of formulae that we will come across now. Now once you know all these things, and also we know trigonometric ratios of special angles, 0 degrees, 30 degrees, 45 degrees, 60 degrees and 90 degrees, 180 degrees, etc. So you can easily calculate sine of pi by 2 minus theta, sine of pi by 2 plus theta, etc. So sine of pi by 2 minus theta means what? It will be sine of, use the formula of sine A minus B. So it will be what? Sine of pi by 2 minus theta will be sine pi by 2 cos theta minus cos pi by 2 sine theta. And once you use the values of sine pi by 2, cos pi by 2, etc., we know that sine pi by 2 is, what is sine pi by 2? You should know. See, such formulae, such things we should always remember. So sine 90 is 1. When you use all those things, you get sine pi by 2 minus theta is cos theta. Then cos pi by 2 minus theta, you use the formula cos A minus B. In place of A, you put pi by 2. In place of B, you put theta. So cos pi by 2 minus theta will be sine theta, and tan pi by 2 minus theta is cot theta. It is easy to remember. Sin pi by 2 minus theta comes out to be cos theta, cos pi by 2 minus theta is sin theta, and tan pi by 2 minus theta is cot theta. When you come to pi by 2 plus theta, trigonometric ratios of pi by 2 plus theta, you know pi by 2 plus theta is the angle in second quadrant. Pi by 2 is 90, so 90 degrees plus theta, it is angle in second quadrant. So what will be sin pi by 2 plus theta? You know, when angle is in second quadrant, sine is positive, cos and tan are negative. So we should always know that whenever I am going for sine of pi by 2 plus theta, it will be positive. And if you use the formula sine a plus b, and in place of a you put pi by 2, in place of b you put theta, then the formula will be what? Sin pi by 2 cos theta plus cos pi by 2 sin theta. Out of that, sin pi by 2 is 1, cos pi by 2 is 0. So you get sin pi by 2 plus theta as cos theta, cos pi by 2 plus theta as minus sin theta, and tan pi by 2 plus theta as minus cot theta. So these are another additional 6 formulae. Then you can think of pi plus theta and pi minus theta. Again, same story. Use the formulae in place of sine. You know, you have the formula sine of a minus b. If I want to calculate sine pi minus theta, replace a by pi and b by theta and use that formula. Put the values of sine pi and cos pi, which already you know. So if you calculate on your own, this will be sin pi minus theta will be sin theta. Because see, pi minus theta is angle in second quadrant, so sin will be positive. Cos of pi minus theta is minus cos theta, because angle pi minus theta is in second quadrant, cos theta is negative, minus cos theta, cos is negative, so it will be minus cos theta. And tan pi minus theta is minus tan theta. Similarly, if you go for pi plus theta, trigonometric ratios of pi plus theta. Pi plus theta is angle in third quadrant. So their sine and cos is negative. Tan is positive. So sine pi plus theta will be minus sine theta. Cos of pi plus theta will be minus cos theta. And tan of pi plus theta is tan theta. See, there is one easy way to remember. When it is pi by 2 plus or minus something, pi by 2, then you do one thing. You make sine cos, cos as sine, tan as cot. What I want to say is, if it is pi by 2 plus theta, then sine of pi by 2 plus theta will be cos theta. Sine of pi by 2 plus theta will be cos theta. And then you check the sine before the right hand side member. It is pi by 2 plus theta, so you are in second quadrant, so it will be positive, so it will be plus cos theta. If you want to calculate cos of pi by 2 plus theta, cos becomes sine, so it will be on the right hand side sine theta. What will be the sine before that? As it is cos you are calculating and in second quadrant, that because pi by 2 plus theta is angle in second quadrant. So cos of pi by 2 plus theta is not just sine theta, it will be minus sine theta. Like that, whenever I am calculating trigonometric ratios of pi plus theta or pi minus theta, keep sine as sine, cos as cos, tan as tan, and just take care of sine on the right hand side. Sine of pi plus theta, it will be sine theta. But what will be the sine before that? As pi plus theta is angle in third quadrant, sine will be negative. So sine of pi plus theta will be minus sine theta. Cos of pi plus theta, it will be cos theta, but what will be sine before cos theta? Minus. Why? Because pi plus theta is angle in third quadrant. But when you go to tan of pi plus theta, it will be tan theta, and third quadrant means tan is positive. This is how you can remember these things easily. Or you can actually calculate by knowing previous results. about sine a plus b, sine a minus b, cos a plus b, cos a minus b, tan a plus b, tan a minus b. You can calculate these things. See, two things always I tell my students. One thing is, either you develop the ability to calculate the things, or you learn those things by heart. So all these formulae that we have seen are very, very important. Now, using these formulae, you can also find double angle formulae like sine 2 theta. Now, this sine 2 theta you can write as sine of theta plus theta. So, in place of in the formula sine of a plus b, you put both a and b as theta. So, what is formula for sine a plus b? It is sine a cos b plus cos a sine b. So, it will be sine theta cos theta plus cos theta sine theta. So, it will be 2 sine theta cos theta. So, sine 2 theta is equal to 2 sine theta cos theta. Also, this formula can be written in terms of tan theta. So, sine 2 theta is having two outcomes. One is 2 sine theta cos theta. Another is 2 tan theta upon 1 plus tan square theta. So, this is the formula of sine 2 theta in terms of tan theta. 2 tan theta upon 1 plus tan square theta. Then you have formula cos of 2 theta. Again, same story. You can use the formula of cos of a plus b, and in place of a and b put theta. So, what is formula for cos of a plus b? It is cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. So, when you put cos of 2 theta, it becomes cos square theta minus sin square theta. Out of that, we know that sin square theta is 1 minus cos square theta by using fundamental identities. So, it will be cos square theta minus 1 minus cos square theta. So, it becomes 2 cos square theta minus 1. Also, the basic formula of cos of 2 theta, cos square theta minus sin square theta. Out of that, cos square theta, if you put as 1 minus sin square, which is legal because sin square plus cos square is 1. So, this formula becomes 1 minus sin square theta minus sin square theta. So, 1 minus 2 sin square theta. And also in terms of tan, it can be written as 1 minus tan square theta upon 1 plus tan square theta. So, cos 2 theta have 3 different formulas. Actually, you can say 4 different formulae. First is cos square minus sin square, which is basic formula. Then 1 minus 2 sin square theta, 2 cos square theta minus 1. And also in terms of tan, it is 1 minus tan square theta upon 1 plus tan square theta. So, these are the 4 formulae corresponding to cos of 2 theta. Then tan of 2 theta. Tan of 2 theta you can easily develop by using tan of a plus b. In place of a and b, put theta. So, tan 2 theta will be tan theta plus tan theta upon 1 minus tan theta into tan theta. So, it will be 2 tan theta upon 1 minus tan square theta. This is the formula for tan 2 theta. Now, when you developed the formula of cos of 2 theta, the byproducts are, you know, cos of 2 theta is 2 cos square theta minus 1. So, that minus 1 you take on left hand side. So, it becomes 1 minus cos 2 theta and 1 plus cos 2 theta. These two formulae we can develop as a byproduct of those formulae of cos of 2 theta. So, 1 plus cos 2 theta is equal to 2 cos square theta. And 1 minus cos 2 theta is equal to 2 sin square theta. So, these are two outcomes of the formulae of cos of 2 theta. And finally, you can develop formulae for sin 3 theta, cos 3 theta, tan 3 theta. For that, what we have to do? Sin 3 theta, you can write as sin of 2 theta plus theta. And use the formula of sin of a plus b. So, it will become sin 2 theta cos theta plus cos 2 theta sin theta. Again, put values of sin 2 theta and cos 2 theta. And while putting cos 2 theta, use the formula of cos 2 theta, which is totally in terms of sine. So when you calculate all these things, finally you get sine 3 theta as 3 sine theta minus 4 sine cube theta. And cos 3 theta will be 4 cos cube theta minus 3 cos theta. Similarly, tan 3 theta we can calculate. What is the way? Put 3 theta as 2 theta plus theta. Then use formula of tan of A plus B. Inside that, so it will be tan of 2 theta plus tan theta upon 1 minus tan 2 theta into tan theta. And so finally, when you calculate, it will be 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta upon 1 minus 3 tan square theta. So these are the formulae which we call as trigonometric functions of compound angles. I hope you enjoyed this audio. Thank you.